let's do 6-6. Yeah, let's upgrade. Let them say that our own is too much, right? Okay, so the listening plane is like 1.2 meters, and this point here, where the gallery start from, is 3 meters, right? So 1.2 is around 4 meters, thereabouts. So within 3 and 4 is the area where we would be getting sound, right? That's where people will be. So one of the things I like to do is, because I may not be able to achieve a tilt down, right? One of the things that I do is I will move my line array so that it faces and feels that point where I want it to be. Do you understand? I make my line array to be tall enough so that the first box is eating on the gallery where I want it to be. So that way I don't have to achieve that bend down. So that I'm not bothering the rigging guy and I'm not bothering all the roofing guys, right? So I haven't said that. So I'm going to point the first one all the way up there. And how do I tilt the speakers? That means that when we're talking about splay angles, I cannot, a lot of people used to install line array like this. So as you can see these lines, this is where the array is pointing to. So if I predict this now for us to see, yeah. Oh, okay. Oh, network is gone. It's coming back. Connected. Yeah, good. So if I predict this, as you can see, this is what's happening in my hall, right? The only people enjoying the sound are people that are seated up here. Everybody here, except people that are here, that are getting a spill of it. Everybody in this area, these ones are under the gallery here. Abby? These people here is rubbish. So most of the power is going straight up, right? Is that how sound should be? No. We're supposed to have even coverage from front to back. So how do we achieve that? We're going to be splaying the speakers. And to achieve that, we're going to go direct. So I'm going to draw the line at 2/3 of the distance from 0 to 17.6. So can someone do, or let me do the calculations. 2 divided by 3. So for some of us that don't like maths, welcome to the club. You have decided to be an audio engineer, so you are going to do maths for the rest of your life. So times 17.6. So that's at 11.7 roughly. So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to draw a line at 11.7. So somewhere here, let me draw that line somewhere here, and let me check the parameters to make sure that it's at that point. Control I. That's okay, that was close. 11.3. No, point what? 7. Oh, sorry. I was thinking 3, not 7. So 11.7 meters. That's the line. Now I'm going to draw a line from the center of the array to that point, right? So that I can calculate the angle that I'm going to use to tilt the line array. So when I draw this, I have, I check the properties of that line to check the angle, control I. And as you can see it here, the angle here says 14.5 degrees, right? We are lost. Okay, let me start again. So one of the things I said I'm going to do is I want to try and get the angle of how to split the array. What do I mean by that? What I mean by that is if I do Control I, under here you can see 0 degrees, right? That's the split angle. And those split angles are on line arrays by the side. There are some numbers there. Yeah, those are the split angles. So it's whichever number that I click here that will determine how it's curving, right? So I want to get what angle will I put on speaker 2? What angle will I put on speaker 3? I can play around with it and keep adding values and keep singing, oh, this is how it is, this is how it is. Or I can use a method, which I am about to use to show you how to get how to do the splaying, right? So, like I said, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a line at 2/3 of the distance. What do I mean by 2/3 of the distance? From front to back. I calculate 2/3 of that distance and I draw a line that is here. So 2/3 times 2/3 times 17.6 is 2/3 of the distance. Yes, times 17.6. Two-third. I said you draw a line at 2/3. 2/3 is 2. Yes. Yes. Oh my God. You need to go to English school. Okay. So once you get that, right? So we will get 2/3, right? And we'll get 11.7, which I got over here, right? So once I get here, I now draw a line from the center of the array, which is this point, right? And I draw it all the way to 2/3 here. Right? So once I have drawn that line, I now need to get the angle. The reason for drawing that line is I want to get the angle between here and the uppermost line so that I know what angles I am adding to the first three boxes. Right? So when I do Control I, it shows me the properties of the line. And the angle here is minus 14.2, right? So forget about the minus and just have 14.2 in mind. The reason why we're using 14.2 is, remember, this array, we are not tilting it, is on zero. So zero minus the other angle is 14.2. Do you understand it? If this array was tilted down already, to achieve a tilt, whichever angle I see here as the angle is what I will subtract from the other angle of the line to get the angles I will use for the top three boxes. So having said that, I now have 14.2. So the first speaker, I will leave it at zero. Then the next speaker, I will use -7, right? Then the third speaker too, I will use -7. That's approximately 14.2. Do we understand? No. So I am trying to spread that angle that I got on the first three boxes. Remember, I drew the line halfway, right? So I'm trying to get the angling of the first three boxes. That's what I'm trying to get. If I have four speakers and the angle is 14.2, I have to divide 14.2 amongst the four speakers. Do you understand it? Yeah.